In one of my previous videos, I unboxed, assembled and tested this Ender 3 V2 and I even made a couple of projects using this printer. But I needed a few upgrades to keep it more reliable and easy to use. So in this video, I'll quickly show you a few of my upgrades I did to my 3D printer, including the Octoprint setup for controlling my 3D printer over a local network. So without any further delay, let's get started. When it comes to 3D printing, it's extremely necessary that we nail the first layer because that's what holds the rest of the print in place. For this, the nozzle has to be perfectly parallel as possible to the hot end. Therefore, it's very crucial that the bed is leveled perfectly. Since the Ender 3 V2 doesn't have auto bed leveling, we have to use the knobs to adjust the bed. You would have seen this bed leveling technique in many other entry-level 3D printers as well. But I sort of had some trouble with this method. The spring that comes with the printer doesn't hold the position of the bed for long enough. They just drift after every print. I had to re-level the bed again before a new print, which was annoying me a lot. So I got myself the springs which are more sturdy and also less springy. Now all I had to do was just change the existing springs with the new ones. And that should be pretty simple as unscrewing the knob and replacing the new springs. But just make sure to remove the spring in the left top corner carefully, as it has been screwed with the temperature sensor as well. Once that's done, let's move on to upgrade number 2. This upgrade isn't that necessary. I'm just doing this for a long-term usage. If you think this is unnecessary, you can totally ignore it. This is an extruder setup of the Ender 3 V2. And this part is completely made of plastic. It looks sturdy at first, but many complain that the hinge breaks pretty soon and the plastic wears out, so it doesn't hold well for long-term usage. So I bought this all-metal extruder setup to replace this plastic one. There was no major upgrade was required. Now let's see how we can upgrade the firmware. Since this model of Ender 3 comes with a 32-bit microcontroller, it's pretty easy to install the firmware when compared to its previous models. All you have to do is just find the right firmware that you need to install. In my case, I'm going to use the JS firmware. He did a great job adding tons of features from bed leveling to customizing the display. So I downloaded the firmware and copied to the SD card. Once you have the firmware on the SD card, just turn off the printer, insert the SD card and restart the printer. This will automatically flash the new firmware to your 3D printer. As a final upgrade, I need a way to monitor the printer so I can do other work while the printer is printing. So I installed Octoprint. This is a small piece of software that gives you access to your 3D printer, where you can set and read the temperature of your bed, send commands to the printer to control the stepper motors, and also upload files directly from your computer even without removing the SD card. For this, all you need is a Raspberry Pi and some 3D printed enclosure. Just go to the Octopi website and download the Octopi image, then copy them to the SD card using Etcher. You can find more details on how to download and install the Octopi on their download page. If this is your first time using Raspberry Pi, I would recommend you to watch my video on how to set up Raspberry Pi without keyboard and a monitor, which should help you with the basics on how to connect to the Raspberry Pi wirelessly. Once the image was installed in the Pi, the assembly was all about just sliding the Pi into the printer aluminum extrusion and powering it with a proper power supply. If you don't like having multiple wires, you can open the printer from the bottom and tap into the 24V from the meanwell power supply, and then later add a buck boost converter to reduce the voltage to 5V DC, where you can connect that to the Raspberry Pi. After it's powered on, you can just access the Octoprint on any browser by searching for octoprint.local in your browser URL. Once you have the access, just set up the info that the software asks and set up a password to later open the Octoprint. This upgrade really helped me manage my STL files and also made easy to monitor the status of 3D printing remotely. And along with this, I have also tried to set up Octolabs to create some cool looking time-lapse videos. But I'm still in the process of getting the video right because I'm not quite happy with the quality of the video that I get from this webcam. Maybe I'll upgrade this with a better webcam and post the result on my Instagram page later. I think this concludes the video. If you watched it so long and enjoyed it, hit the like button. And if you have any questions, you can comment them below. Please let me know any upgrades that I can do to my 3D printer which would help me improve the 3D printing experience. Until next time, you can watch my other videos from the link on the screen or from the link in the description.